if you do another episode, you should mention accounts that have golden sights. You know what? I will do another video because it's come to my attention that in the last video, I didn't do justice to the rarest accounts in RuneScape. In fact, many of the accounts brought to my attention are so bizarre that there's actually little documented about them. You're gonna see what I mean by that. And worse, I missed some crucial facts. Remember that level 1 account? Turns out Buddy hacked it. We don't know who the original owner is. I've got a lot of information on that and so much more, so today we're taking another deep dive into the rarest accounts in RuneScape's history. But first, this video is brought to you by NordVPN, whom I will now briefly thank. The last time NordVPN sponsored my channel, I gave a cautionary tale of the time I went to a malicious RuneScape player's website, saw they had an IP logger in the code, and had I not had NordVPN on, my real IP address would have been exposed. They could have DDoSed me, or they could have used it to figure out the city I live in. Luckily, it wasn't an issue because NordVPN protects you from all of that. Now, maybe you don't care about not getting DDoSed while you're in a stake or in a PK fight. Maybe you care about saving money. Check this out, if you're in America and you want to buy a year worth of membership, it's going to cost you $100. But if you use NordVPN and connect to a Canadian server, open up a new incognito window to buy membership, it only costs you $90 because of the exchange rate. Or check this out, one of Rendy's recent videos got geo-blocked in a bunch of countries. I open up NordVPN, I connect to Japan, and now I can watch that video. There's a bunch of other use cases too, and luckily for you, it's NordVPN's birthday, so they have a special deal on. If you purchase a 2-year membership, you'll get 1 month for free, plus an additional surprise gift. You can go to nordvpn.com/crumb or use coupon code crumb on checkout to take advantage of this. Link is in the description. Thank you, NordVPN. Now, unlike the first video where I ordered the accounts from least rare to most rare, this time we're going from mundane to bizarre. In 2011, Jagex introduced into the game a new discontinued holiday item which is more rare than party hats, Christmas crackers, or even the warship. It's known as the Golden Scythe, and just 25 players have it on their account. Worse, it's rumored some of the owners have now been banned from the game, so it's likely that number is even lower. But why would Jagex decide in the first place to introduce such a rare item into the game? They did this as an event at RuneFest in 2011, which was coincidentally taking place just before Halloween. In-game, at that time, there was a Halloween event known as DeathCon 2, and so they made a spin-off of this for RuneFest attendees to participate in person. The first 25 people that handed in their questionnaire decoding the message were given a code to redeem a Golden Scythe in-game. According to Omastardo, a player who actually got one of these, he said that at RuneFest, they made no mention this item would be rewarded. Nobody knew that they could possibly get one by rushing through this in-person event. Now, once people caught wind that this item was in-game and it was only given to 25 players, it caused huge controversy for a number of reasons. People said they would have went to RuneFest had they known they could have got this item. People said that this devalued the only other scythe in the game at this time, the one from the 2003 Halloween event, which was symbolic of old players. And finally, they were complaining that there's just 25 of them in the game. It got so bad that ModMattK had to make a PR message to save face. He argues against all these points and then ends his message with, "If you see someone with one, make sure you take a screenie as you won't see them often." Now, I think that rarity on its own is not enough to make an account interesting. Whatever the rare thing is, it also has to have perceived value. Check this out, there is a few people on RuneScape 3 who have one-off titles. They are the only ones in the game with them, so technically they are the rarest. But for whatever reason, these don't light a wow factor when I see them. Not like accounts that have a 15-year veteran cape on an Iron Man or Hardcore Iron Man on RuneScape 3. If you're the keen perceptive type, do you know why this is a strange occurrence? It's because the Iron Man mode was released in 2014. That's 7 years ago, something isn't adding up. So these Iron Men with veteran capes are people who created accounts way back then but never went past the character creation screen. And so after the new game mode was released and they logged in, they could still set the account to be an Iron Man. A few of you noticed this on the black market that I showed in my last video. I completely missed this. But they do have a perceived value, and there they are. One interesting thing here is that these are actually fleeting. Once we hit the 10-year mark from 2014, a whole bunch of new Iron Man accounts will gain access to these capes. So unless they make a new 20-year veteran cape, 25-year veteran cape, these will lose their novelty. Now, there is a recent achievement in old school RuneScape that is no longer possible. This has rendered these accounts extremely rare. That is, level 3s with fire capes. There's just two of these accounts in-game and they're owned by Rendy and Zacht. They both uploaded videos showing how they did this with a multitude of obscure strategies. One of these strategies was known as the shield interface method, and it's no longer possible to do this method because Jagex had to remove it to patch a potential dupe in the game. See, this past December, following Worlds crashing offline, they found that players were abusing stackable interfaces to potentially dupe items. So to prevent a potentially catastrophic economic event, they had to patch stackable interfaces, thus rendering level 3 fire cape completions impossible. This wasn't the only in-game activity adversely affected either. They list a few of them on their blog post about this. I would argue these are the most desirable accounts on this list because number 1, they're no longer possible, number 2, Rendy's Lower the Better series added so much hype around them, and number 3, it creates a reaction of bewilderment from unaware players. Furthermore, they're old school RuneScape accounts. You'll notice many rare accounts are on RuneScape 3, so one could say it's rarer to have a rare account on old school. We're going to digress now back to the life-hated account, the level 1 I mentioned in the first part of this video. If you remember, this account was created because Jagex reset all of their levels to just 1 way back in the early days of RuneScape as a punishment for botting. Only a few of these accounts lived on to make it into the modern era of the game. It turns out that the person who was playing on the life-hated account was not the original owner. He hacked it, and while the account still exists, it has been permanently locked by Jagex, never to be played again unless the real owner recovers it. Now, what if I told you I have the login details to this account? So the account was originally hacked by a person under the alias Command19872002. After I made the first video, one of his old friends reached out to me, shared with me the login credentials to prove his story, and gave me a little background that this guy was using account cracking software to hack accounts for profit back in 2010 to 2011. And Lifehated happened to be one of the accounts that they got. You can see now when I try to log into it, it's been permanently locked by Jagex. This is because they've detected that it was stolen. And so this is why no one has seen the account since Command 1987 originally posted those videos in May of 2010. But what this does mean is that the original owner is out there somewhere, so they could possibly recover the account by proving to Jagex that they are the original owner and they would have a level 1 in the game. Hey, if you've been enjoying the videos, consider subscribing. I'd really like to hit 100,000 so I unlock the final tier of creator benefits. Now this next one is caused by a combination of mistakes made by Jagex. As one Redditor put it, this occurrence created one hell of a peer. Back in March of 2019, Jagex made a mistake which resulted in 24 accounts having their defense level improperly reset to 1. A few of these 24 accounts had Recipe for Disaster done, that is, they had the powerful Barrows gloves unlocked. These gloves don't have a defense requirement to wear, but you do have to complete the quest to get them, and that's not possible without getting at least 41 defense. To equip them at level 1 is a peer's wet dream. They provide a significant stat boost, and so when images of these accounts started being posted on Reddit, Jagex had to respond to the situation quickly to mitigate it. So how did it happen in the first place, what did Jagex do about it, and why might there still be a few left in the game? In February of 2019, there was a very short-lived bug with the autocast feature which resulted in a few peers getting unwanted defense experience. Unlike what we've observed in the past, Jagex decided they would fix their mistake by resetting the defense level for those affected peers. Here's where the second mistake happened. Mod Gambit said 24 accounts were mistakenly reset to level 1 defense, accounts that shouldn't have been reset in the first place, and that's how these accounts came to be. Worse, he wrote that in order to fix these accounts, the players actually had to be online, and so they reached out to each of those players trying to coordinate that. We don't know if Jagex ever managed to fix all of these accounts. I suppose it might be possible that some of these accounts never coordinated a time with Jagex, and so after some time has passed, perhaps the issue slipped the mind of the Jagex moderator responsible for handling these resets, and so a few of these accounts may still exist in the game. That said, I think if they ever appear in public, they'll end up on Reddit and then their accounts will be reset. This next one we're looking at is accounts that have smuggled dungeoneering items. Jagex has gone to great lengths to make this no longer possible, and to systematically remove any of these items upon use for someone that still might have them in their bank. So the months following the release of Dungeoneering in 2010, players found a multitude of ways to get items out of the Dungeoneering minigame, or skill as Jagex called it. At first, these items were fully usable, you could actually equip and use the items outside of Dungeoneering. It was a very neat sight, and a whole black market sprung up around people selling these items. Now, Jagex quickly patched this bug and they started introducing checks. If you tried to put an item in your bank, for example, take an item out of your bank, equip it, use it on something, it would crumble to dust. At first, Jagex wasn't perfect in these checks, and so that black market persisted. For example, to trade an item between players, one of the methods was to go to a free-to-play world, drop the dungeoneering item, it had to be a member's dungeoneering item, and then have the person who was buying it telegrab it off of the floor. Then, that person would go to their player-owned house and use their butler to put it in their bank. I think they've now patched all of these methods, so anybody that has dungeoneering items still in their bank definitely has a rare account, but they can no longer touch any of those items or they will crumble to dust. That is, they will be deleted from the game. They can't even feed them to their baby troll anymore. That's a pet in RuneScape 3, which will take on the name of any item that you feed it. And so before Jagex introduced all these rigorous checks, people used to feed those dungeoneering items to their baby trolls to have a unique name. Those are now rare too. Now I think that about covers it for the rare accounts on RuneScape. If I've missed any, please let me know in the comments section below. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button, it helps me out a lot, and I'll see you guys in the next one.